Yo, Adam Sachs from GynaCuban. In this video, we are going to revisit the slicer panel. It needs an update, a new coat of paint, if you will. It was done years ago, and I want to get it in the current state of what Power BI is today as we go into 2023. All right, let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, slicer panel. I did this video years ago. We need to update it as we go into 2023. We've got the new green accent color. I just want to make sure all the clicks are current to what you experienced today because some things changed over a couple of years. I'm also going to answer a few questions that came up in the other video and maybe show something that I didn't show before. All right, enough of all this talking. You know we like to do it here on Guy Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. First things first, a question was asked in that video of, hey, if you create the slicer pane, can I reuse it on every page? I'll answer that in the context of the actual slicer pane when we get there. But what I want to talk about first is this concept of a slicer page instead of a pane. And so what you'll see here is I've got an actual slicer page, got all my slicers. Ooh, they're so pretty. So I just created a page and I added a button here. These are navigation buttons, right? So if I look at this navigation button, the action is just going to take me back to the overview page. And so when I click on that, it comes back to the overview page. I added a button over my little filter and all this action is doing is going to the slicer page and that's it. So if I go back and go to view and we'll go to sync slicers. Sync slicers is the magic here. And this is how this is affecting all pages in the report. We can actually go through and we can say, yes, I want the slicers on this page to affect all of the other pages, but they're only visible on the slicer page itself. So as I change these, they will change across all pages, which is amazing. And that's how this works. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward, but this can be very powerful if you want a central location where people can go to create those actual slicers and, you know, adjust them. And it makes it fairly easy if you want on every page just a single button that goes to the slicer page, that can be accomplished. All right, now on to the slicer pane. Okay, so we're starting here with a report. I don't have my button here, so I can't click on anything. So what we want to do first is we want to get the basis of what the slicer pane is going to be. So the first thing we're going to do is go to the insert bar, and then I'm going to do shapes. Let's do rounded rectangle, right? And so we can come and we can create this and then we can edit it up. So probably don't need it to be that big. And we can come in, you can adjust and tinker with different things. So like, let me get rid of the background so it's kind of transparent on the rounded. We can come into the shape, rounded corners. Maybe I just want this to be 10% so it's not as pronounced. And then you can adjust the color too. So if we come into style, color, maybe I don't want it as loud of a blue. So yeah, it's pretty nice. Fill, and then the border, we can just say, maybe we want a black for clean separation. Cool. What we're going to want to do now is add our actual slicer and we'll add a field. So what do we want? First one we're going to do is maybe the year, and then we'll change this to a dropdown for consistency's sakes. All of them are going to be a dropdown, and then we can tinker around more with this. So what I want is on the formatting pane, we're going to go into general effects. I don't want a background. Oh, but that looks really not usable. So let's go back to the visual. And if we go to values, then the font color there, let's change that to black. And then we can come into background. That's what we want. Change the background of the values to white. And that way this is visible. And then the year is visible as well. Maybe we want to make that bold to make it stand out a little more. You can tinker around with this to get the slicer the way you want it to look. And then what we'll do is we'll get all of the slicers in here, right? So like a great cooking show, I've already got that done and life is good. So now what we need to do is we actually need to play around with the selections of these and let's start grouping things together. So let me go to view and we're going to bring up the selection pane and we'll see here that we've got all of our slicers here. So I did double click on these to name them so I know what they are. This makes it really easy when you're trying to navigate through and understand which item is there. If you just see slicer, 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 it's hard to figure out what's what when you're trying to group things, when you're trying to interact with things. So just take the time, name your visuals. You'll thank me later. So now what I want to do is I'm going to select and then we'll go all the way down to slicer background and we can group these. But wait, there's one more thing I want to do. One of the questions also in the video was about, well, hey, I know you're going to end up with a close button here to close the slicer pane, but what if I click outside? Like I want something to click outside so it goes away as well. Like what happens there? This is where the magic of buttons are going to come in. So we need to get some buttons in here before we go and group these up. So let's go and do that. We're going to go to insert and we're going to go to buttons. We're going to add two buttons here. One, I'm going to do a blank button. This is going to be our close button and we're going to turn on text. I'm just going to put an X. Let's make it bold and we'll make it bigger. That's good. And then go to general effects, turn off background, and we're going to turn off button style. Let's turn off border and we'll turn off icon too. So we're just going to have text on here and we'll size that up a little bit. So this will be our close button, right? So what we're going to do now is we're going to add another button. Let's do a blank button and we're going to make it the whole page. And we'll do the same things before. So let's go to effects. Let's turn the background gray. And then I'm going to change transparency to 75. So it kind of gives it more of a gray tone. And I'm going to turn off the border. So again, just tinkering. Let's play with all the properties to get it to look the way we want. Let's do X button, full page close. And then what I want to do is bring this full page close below the slicer background, right? So now we've got all our buttons in place for the slicer pane. We will go through, select all of them, and then we're gonna group and rename it slicer pane. Now, what I wanna do is I wanna hide this, and we've got this other button that's sitting here, right? So you can add this button, and you'll notice if I actually move this off, the background image just has a white version of it. The button itself is this gray color. What I did here is there's different states. So default is going to be this gray color for the fill. So I'm just playing with transparency here. So if you look at on press, it's 57%. On hover, it's 100%, which means you go through, and then default is 57% as well. And this is our slicer pane button. Let's just go move that up. We need to make sure it's below this info page because of other usability items. So we've got our slicer pane button here to open it up. And then we've got our button inside of the slicer pane itself. So now let's go to view and we'll go to bookmarks. And we already have some existing bookmarks, but we need to create a bookmark for our slicer pane itself. So here, what I wanna do is I'm gonna select the slicer pane. We're gonna say add bookmark and we'll say slicer panel open. And then we'll make another one. It's closed and we'll say add slicer panel closed. Cool. So if we go to open, we'll see that it's open, but we need to adjust these bookmarks a little bit. So let's go through. We're going to uncheck data because I don't want this to reset the selection. I did a whole video on like mastering bookmarks. So definitely go check that out if you want to learn about these settings and how they apply. It can trip you up if you forget. I've been there. I forgot that it was checked and I'm like, why is this happening? Why is it resetting for some weird reason? And it was because of this check mark. So data is undone. I do want display and I don't want current page. Now, the other thing I want to do, make sure the slicer panel group is selected. And I want to say selected visuals only and then update. So what this means is this bookmark's only going to affect the visuals that are within the slicer pane. It's not gonna touch anything else. And we definitely want that because we don't want it to affect state of anything else. And then slicer pane close, we're gonna do the same thing, right? So we wanna uncheck data. We wanna uncheck current page. And we wanna change it to selected visuals. Make sure that slicer pane is selected. And then we'll say update visual. So now if we open, we're good. And if we close, we're good. Now we can go back in and we can wire up a couple things. So first off, let's go to the X and we're gonna change the action. We're gonna turn this on bookmark and we'll change it to slicer pane closed. And then we're gonna select this full page item. We're gonna do the same thing. So now both of these are selected correctly. If we close it, we open it, everything's good. Now I'm gonna close it. We're gonna go back to this button and we'll change it from bookmark and we'll say slicer pane open. So now if I select this item, it should open. And then if I select this one, it closes. If I do open again and then click out here, it closes as well. So everything's working. You might be saying, Adam, we're almost done. Ooh, wait, in the beginning of the video, I told you about sync slicers, right? So let's go look at that. Let's go back to the open state. I'm gonna close the selections because we don't need that anymore, but I am gonna open up sync slicers. Again, going back to the original question that was posed, how do I affect these on every page? In terms of the slicer panel, you'd have to recreate this on every page if you wanted this look in each page that you had in your report. But on your overview page, if you wanted, you could get these slicers as you select them to affect every page in general. The challenge there is you're gonna have to come back to the overview page to do it. And it's a little clunky, but it is an option. It is something you could play with in terms of navigation and user experience, things of that nature. So let's just go wire up sync slicers, assuming that that's what you wanted to go do. I'm not necessarily advocating that you actually take this approach, but I want to illustrate how you could do it. So again, we can select our year slicer. You have to do this for each slicer that's in the list. And as we go through, we want to make sure that we are syncing it with each page and then unselecting it so it's only visible on the overview page. And then we would do this for each one. Again, like a cooking show, all of these are wired up for sync slicers as well. So if I make a change on one of these slicers, it will affect every page that is selected here. So in this case, every page that's in my report, and then you can go forth and have fun with those slicer selections. All right, that gets us to the final product. So I want to hand this over to you. What do you think? Are you using slicer panes? Are you leaning towards just the filter pane? Do you use a mix of both? Tell me why down in the comments below. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.